Decisive stare, the time it takes to get from here to there. Rely a bit too heavily on alcohol and irony. Get clobbered on by courtesy. In love with love and lousy poetry.
I'm gonna go take people's reactions and see what they think.
What'd you do? Oh my god! Oh fucking, that's fucking dope, dude.
When did you do that?
I just got it.
Really?
It's cool, eh?
Fuck.
Most Canadians I've met is pretty friendly.
How long have you been?
I think they are very familiar with foreigners, like people like me, but sometimes I just can't speak their lingo because I don't understand what really they're talking about. Even in lectures, you can say that, you know, when the prof is telling me this thing, sometimes I don't even get it. It's not that I don't understand, but my mind doesn't function that fast.
And so he has a religious conversion almost. Okay, so then he moves on to the next city, he dresses up nicely.
One of my greatest problem here is that my language, I speak with a very funny accent, even I don't like it. Yeah, I speak fast, and okay, I have to slow down a bit, yeah.
When you are ready to move the stove, just wave.
When you are ready to move the stove, just wave.
When you are ready to move the stove, just wave. When you are ready to move the stove, stove.
I don't have any fuzz on my clothes. He won a prize with his big brown eyes. I nearly froze when waiting in line for the jazz concert.
The concrete resolution is that I would like to get fit, because the only reason I'm unfit right now is because I was depressed. Like, it's not normal for me either. I'm a very active person normally. The other one is I'm not gonna beat up on myself anymore. That's a terrible habit that I developed. Half the problem with being depressed, as it were, is that when anything went wrong, I would come back to myself as the cause. Broken and unrecovered. With so much to say, and so much to be discovered.
The sleeves are a little short.
You want a 36-24-36.
This is another one of my concrete resolutions, is that I would like to go out on a lot more dates. When you feel really low about yourself, it's pretty hard to put yourself out there.
Hey, there you go, $25.
Really?
Yeah, what a bargain.
So that is one of my main ways I'd like to have fun. I'd like to meet more girls.
All right, I'll talk to you later. Bye-bye. Oh man, everybody's studying. Nobody wants to come out with Chrissy. It's always the way.
I've been thinking about it a lot, but what appeals to me from living so far away from where I'm from, and one thing that I take comfort in is that when I'm in Vancouver, I can pretend that my father's still alive and that he's safe and that he's living in Toronto. And I don't really have to think about the fact that he's not around and that I can never talk to him again and never see him again. It's just kind of like, I'm just across the country, but I'll be back and he'll come to me and visit, and you know, I'm just not seeing him or able to talk to him right now. So it's kind of, it takes away the foreverness of the fact that he's gone. It's just, I just kind of realized that that's the way I see it. And it really calms me, because that's probably one of the most disturbing things about someone so important to you dying, that it's just, it's forever and it's final. And you'll just never see them again.
One of the key things that is going on in my life is my relationship with my father.
Yeah, it's not a problem.
I can see that he is trying to make the effort to make a friendship with me rather than just being a formal relationship. And I'm feeling so happy about that, right?
I didn't listen properly. Yeah. It's all MCQ, so I just like... Can.
He told me straight, if you have not came to Canada, he would not have known how to communicate with me.
So
I ended up with tears in my eyes and asked him, why can't someone teach you all this 5 years ago?
He is taking family studies and parenting, and now he comes back and discusses with me parenting. And he begins to recall. He say, Daddy, this is what you did to me, you know? We studied in classroom.
Things are common sense.
Every human is broken. Even parents make mistakes. My dad made mistakes. But yet, it's a human nature for every person to make a mistake. We can't blame them for that.
My dad was this really strong role model in my life. And he was my inspiration. He was everything I ever wanted to be. But when they broke up, it was like you really saw these two people for who they were, which were just people.
Only one is in second year.
You are young and you are smart and you have nothing to do. Even you don't need to go to work.
I have nothing to do.
No, I mean nothing at home.
It pains me to say anything bad about this man that I've respected for so long, but he has his faults.
Like, will I remember everything?
I was just trying to focus on this. This is an adult relationship that they're having, and so therefore, if they feel that they are happier apart, then they should do that.
I guess when I got back from Ecuador, I was on such a high from talking to my dad that I almost convinced myself that maybe it was completely over with. That all that needed to happen was that I could just identify the problem, and once I actually identified and acknowledged the problem and understood it, then it would be gone. but it's not actually that simple. So some days, like yesterday, the day before, I still have a day where I wake up and I feel low. And it's not logical, it's not even necessarily reasonable. Often there's no significant cause for it, but then it happens.
On some level, I kind of hope that after talking about it with you and like acknowledging that I had been depressed and talking about it, then it would suddenly be...
go away forever.
Well, yeah.
I wish.
Yeah.
I would love to be able to do that for you.
Yeah.
But you're going to have to do things on a daily basis to make yourself happy.
Yeah.
And there's nothing wrong with doing that.
Count yellow highway lines that you're lying on to lead you home. That you're lying on to lead you home.
Hi, Mom. Yeah. All right. Well, I'm gonna wait for my dad to come. He still hasn't seen my haircut yet, so.
Is that Melissa?
Yeah.
Hi. How are you?
I'm good, thank you.
Yeah, this is Melody.
Hi, how are you?
Hello.
Just gonna be chilling.
It's cool.
Oh, I like it. 맞아. 사진 찍잖아.
Is it cool? I'm gonna take it off. It's just fun.
No, I can keep it. I like it.
Dad can't tell me what to do with my hair.
What? No, I can keep it forever.
Like, but Dad sort of thinks anything that's not normal is considered punk. It's like no tattoo, no earring, no anything. He thinks I'm gonna be like a bum or I'm gonna get a minimum wage job. And I'm like, Dad, you know, when I hit my prime in my 40s, I'll be making so much money that I don't even know what to do with it. My dad's like, no, you must be doctor. You must be lawyer. I'm like, Dad, you don't get it, man. Yep. It's just different. I'm a young guy. What am I gonna do this when I'm 40 years old? I'm gonna cut it off.
Yeah.
It's just fun, okay? I'm a young guy. I like
it's
having...
okay.
It doesn't look that bad.
Look again, again, and it's okay.
It doesn't look that bad. But it doesn't look that bad, does it? Does it look terrible? Do I look like a punk?
That's a pin.
Yeah.
Is that
good at all? I love it. Well, my exercise. Okay, mommy. First.
Thank you.
Hey, Mimi. Second.
Okay.
Okay. Okay. Great.
Wish you the best.
They seem to have changed attitude towards me because they know that they'll be leaving soon, right? And they're actually preparing me for independence. They're actually now expecting me to know how to cook, how to do everything myself.
What I'm going to do right now is to pack a few stuff and bring it over to the place I'm going to live.
This is what I'm looking for, actually, to finally learn to be independent and to realize who I am, right? I mean, this is what life is all about.
My only demand of him is he has to be very careful in his choice. But once he make up his choice, he must not turn away. My own personal philosophy is, once you make a choice, you must fall in love with a choice and always out with your choice, no turning back. Because when you are fickle-minded, you will go nowhere.
I would go out at night and then sleep in till like 2 p.m. And it was fun for a while, but I started trying to go to bed, like not go out and just stay at home and try to go to bed like at a decent hour. But then I'd just lie there and toss and turn, and I'd be watching TV for hours and hours, and then the sun would be up. And it was just insane, because I just couldn't function very well. I was so exhausted. And then it just came like a revelation, just all at once. And I was like, oh my God, I know what I have to do. It just came to me. Called me this morning and she was like, why are you giving up the scholarship? And she was really upset. And I can see what she means. I worked for 5 years to get good marks in high school and then to just throw it all away. But from my perspective, why waste 2.5 more years doing something that I'm not enjoying? That's the real loss in my mind. It took me this long to realize that university is not for everybody and it's not necessarily the best option, because that's what you're taught all along. But the best option is something different for everybody. I know how it looks, but in my head I knew, and in my heart I knew that it's not me dropping out of university and ruining my life, because that's just a negative way to look at it. I'm actually making myself happy by doing this. So for me, I think it's getting specific training, hands-on in my field, and then going ahead with it. Thank you.
Okay.
Okay.
Take care. Bye. I see you.
Bye. Bye. Bye.
Bye-bye.
Okay, bye.
It's two things that's going on right now. It's a declaration of blessing of independence, my dad. Something that I've hoped for 20 past years of my life. I'm by myself now. Ready to face the world. It's my life. It's a new world. And I'm going to go on for it.
We'll be right back.
I've been talking about it all year, I guess, you know? And I want to be in a relationship. I'm ready for a relationship again. I want, you know, to have someone that I can talk to or someone that I can meet up and hang out with. The minute I stopped looking, it came. We just started going out, and she just said, you know, how about I make you dinner? She made me this wonderful dinner, and I said, can I help out? Or, you know, she's like, no, get out of my kitchen.
I mean, I lived in an old house.
I realized that I'm quite a hopeless romantic. I like to really, you know, say things that are sweet and nice, and, you know, I tell her how beautiful she looks. It was awesome. Like, she had this great setup in her den where there was a fireplace and a table, and she had candles, and it was sweet.
So I've been looking forward to this. Cheers again. Mm-hmm. I'm old. I'm an old man.
Okay, the funniest thing in the world just happened. Here I am on a Friday night in my mom's place because I'm visiting her for the entire weekend. Now my boyfriend, Jonathan Lowen, decides that after a ruckus, rowdy night of drinking with his friends, that he'll come over and visit me at the end of the night. And I think that's so sweet of him. So I say, you know, go to bed and I'll do my video diary. And he says, sure. And then he decides not only will he be passed out, but also, right as I press record, he should vomit into the garbage can right beside my bed. So, that's a true college romance right there for you. Thank you, John. You look so incredibly handsome.
I think I'm having the best time of my life here in Canada, actually. Experiencing so much of the unknown. Yeah. The restriction for my life is totally off. I have no more restriction. I'm free to go wherever I want. The freedom is exhilarating, yet dangerous, because you know that if you go too far, or you have no boundaries, you're gonna go in a way that is totally off, where you totally again lose your focus in life.
Yeah, okay. I wanted to go out and buy a really, really, really good suit. My previous roommate told me about his sort of philosophy on suit buying, like, you know, buy one every 1 or 2 years as an investment, and then eventually you'll have a collection. It's because he's heading into business, so I sort of adopted that too. I was like a kid in a candy store.
You know, we're limited in sort of those areas.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh yeah, I like that because it has. Turn it on.
Say what you want to hear. When I put the suit on, I felt like a totally different person. I felt like a man of power. I felt like a CEO. I felt like I was a boss, like a manager, that I had a staff of my own. I felt like that I was going somewhere. My dad, I said, hey dad, I bought a new suit. And he's like, how much did you spend? And I was like, I'll tell you later. And he's like, $1,000? And I was like, whoa, that's a really good guess. I didn't think my dad would even guess something like that. I thought he may say like $400 or $500, but he's like, $1,000? And I'm like, I'll tell you later.
I was 500 to 600 over. Sweet, but that's whatever.
Double it.
I don't care. I'm stupid. I'm so dumb.
it's kind of hard to even have this kind of meeting, because in the past I haven't felt comfortable with professors or even like known mm-hmm. how they would respond. So
I think the bottom line is that, you know, you did a lot of good work in the course, and we need to think about ways in which we can try and get you to completion, set up a timetable,
right,
and try and respond to your needs. But that we should try and work out something that makes sure that you complete a sufficient amount of work to legitimately get the credit,
right,
if you were to...
I feel so much better now about getting the work done. And he made this point too. If you're trying to tackle depression and then the side effects of it all by yourself, then it's 100 times harder.
This is good. I'm really very pleased that you came back and that we had a chance to have this meeting.
Well, I really appreciate it. I mean, had I thought more clearly and realized that there was a potential for you to actually help me rather than just for me to get in trouble, then I would have come speak to you earlier.
It would be impossible if everyone were able to go at their own pace. But that doesn't mean that if things go off the rails for individuals, we can't try and respond to that. So that's where we are.
That meeting is probably one of the best things that's happened to me at university. And, well, I'm just glad I had him as a professor for this course. I mean, this is one of the final courses I need to graduate. And so had it turned out differently, who knows what would have happened, right? So now I at least know I'm still going to graduate. I don't know what timeline we'll come up with, but I'm certainly not going to have to take an entire year-long course again.
I'm a little ashamed to say right now that I was really fearful of ending up like my mom, but, like, I mean, a lot of girls have that. I was sort of, like, angry for a while. I was the rebellious teen, and mom was the one I got my anger out on, obviously. As a lot of teenagers end up doing to their parents. So I now respect and know and just appreciate what my mom did for me when I was in high school, because, I mean, now that I think of it, any job would have been better than dealing with me coming home after high school. Seeing John's family and seeing the way me and John interact and how conflict and argument is not normal to this boy. I love my family, but I realize these four people should live apart. These four people should not be together. Now them being split up, I'm actually more comfortable with it, because my family is just a family of opposites and of conflicting personalities. And so I'm more comfortable with everyone being an adult and everyone accepting what makes them happy.
Okay, happy new year, mommy, thank you.
Worrying so much that I wouldn't end up like my mom, I ended up like my dad, and now I don't respect the parts of me that are like that, and so therefore, I'm no one's little girl anymore.
It's been a year now. I figured there's something more by now. It's been a year now. It's been a year now. I figured there'd be something more by now. So what is my objective in that line? It's been a, why would he say that? I figured there'll be something more by now. Like something. Something! Sally, where do you see us going? Am I a friend or a movie buddy? I'm trying to confront. Let's just go to a stupid movie. Just drop it, okay? I love you! What's that? Oh, I figured there'll be something more by now. Something. The TH. Trust me, Sally.
Yeah.
His line here is very vulnerable. He's saying that, Sally, I've been with you longer than anyone else. How can you think I'm not? I've been with you. The problem is that I've never been in a relationship before. Forget it. And it's not funny, okay?
Thank you.
To me, this is my home. This is what my life as a fraternity member is. It's my life as a Fiji has a lot to do with my experiences here. The brothers that I've met and lived with in this house have really shaped me to the kind of person that I am. Before we say goodnight,
oh, protect our secret handshake once more with feeling. Let the toast to absent members push through the ceiling before we say goodnight.
I decided to do another year at school. I want to take fun courses. I'm thinking about taking an acting class or an intro to acting. I'm thinking about taking maybe a script writing class because I have some ideas for scripts. Some of my brothers like, why don't you just go? Why don't you leave, you know? But I'd rather take a few classes and stay on campus with, you know, do one more year in the fraternity and party more. And really enjoy a going out year, like a retirement year. I'll be graduating, so I'll be actively looking for a job. But I mean, it takes time, so why not have some more fun?
I was a high school student during Columbine, and I'm a Middle Eastern person. I'm of Middle Eastern descent during, during 9/11. And it's just that I have these perspectives on things. I have these views that aren't the majority. A visible minority woman getting really high positions, but at the same time never letting go of her social conscience. Like, this is what I want to be part of.
Helping out the system.
You're helping out tonight?
System.
Fabulous, fabulous.
Well, okay. You
know. They saw my enthusiasm and how I'll do anything to help. And so, what do you know? I'm working on campaigns.
I need to confirm with George Tower where the location is tonight.
Oh, you did. Excellent. Now, one of the things I want.
Right now, I can easily say that this is a much more important experience than, you know, the B or the A or whatever grade I would get in some course. So I can sacrifice a bit of academic and know this, that for the long run, this experience will be so much better. Not as a resume building opportunity, but just as life building and life experience building. It's fantastic.
Sally, where do you see us going?
I was hoping the movies. I thought we were having a good time.
Am I a boyfriend or a movie buddy?
There's nothing wrong with just letting things happen.
It's been a year now. I figured there'll be something more by now.
Like what?
Something.
Honestly, this scene actually is something that I really don't like. Because I don't really like to be that physically intimate with a girl, right?
Do you want to move in with me?
Excuse me?
I think we should live together.
Oh, you're insane.
It's a good idea.
Many questions I've asked myself before I'm doing this. I have to make sure that I am not doing anything that's wrong. Yeah, so I don't like that scene, honestly.
And you expect me to believe that you're ready for this kind of commitment?
Just because I have a problem with my folks doesn't mean I have a problem with you. Let's move in together.
The values that's in the scene does not reflect my own values. I don't agree with cohabitation. Acting is acting. It is not a reflection of my values, okay?
You really are insane.
Oh yeah, I got back my grade. I got 90 for my theater, so I was really happy.
lived in for the past 2 years is no longer there. I don't know where that came from, Neil plus Holly. I've never seen that before.
We finally talked and she told me that her feelings changed for me. Her feelings were more platonic than something on a relationship level. And I told her, like, joking, I was like, you know I'm going to be rich and you know I'm going to be very good looking, I'm going to be into fitness and, you know, I'm going to keep my shape and I'm going to always treat you with respect in the future and, you know, like, that's the kind of person I am. And she's like, yes, I know that. You know, I'm already kicking myself in the head right now, but, you know, that's what the heart is. And I, you know, I agree. And it's like, yes, you know, the heart is fickle and it does things that people can't explain. And that's the way it is.
I love tangents.
It's really corny to say, like, oh, you found, you know, love of your life, whatever, in university, because that's what happens to everybody. But, they parented.
I love tangents.
Are you serious? Our 1 year's coming up. Terrifying. In a couple weeks. Things are great. We definitely, now, jokes have turned from, like, haha, you still have to date me for a while, to, like, you have to put up with me, like, the rest of your life. And so, you know, those talks are there now, and just very happy.
I like for kisses. You move about an inch forward, and I have to get up and stand, like, pushing to have a
You know, the fact that I've been at university for 6 years, and this is the single most exciting learning opportunity in terms of a one-day event, a one-off, you know, learning opportunity, it's pretty amazing that it happened when I was still on campus, and I'm really thankful for that.
So, I consider myself here another student or another person who just want to know more, to see more.
A lot of his message was to learn as much as you can about the world, learn as much as you can about other religions so that you can make your own decisions. And I think that falls into trying your hardest to be the best person you can be. He doesn't go up there saying, you know, if you follow Buddhism the way I prescribe, then your life will be happy. For some people, you might want to meditate 5 hours a day. For other people, you might want to just live what you see as a normal life and try to be good to people in small ways that you can. Coming through this difficult year and asking so many people, what is the way to get over this depression? What is the way to get through the difficulties that I've been experiencing, the crazy ups and downs? Realizing that even with 5 panelists, including 3 Nobel Peace Prize winners, and the message is still follow your own path, it makes me realize I'm not looking for a single answer that one person can tell me anymore.
When you open the door, there's this sudden rush of air. And you look down and everything seems to be like ants and you're like, oh great. So you have to step off the plane, grab hold of the plane, let your legs go and start flying in the air. That was the most frightening part. And when you have to let go of your hand, it's like everything's just went blank. You're just like, ah. It's breathtaking. It's just absolutely breathtaking. I realized that the world is free for me to go anywhere. But where will I go for my future? I don't know. But God has a plan for me. And where that plan leads. One step at a time. One step at a time.
Graduation was really exciting. To actually put on the gown was a huge, overwhelming sense of accomplishment. Realizing that after 5 years, I've accomplished probably one of the biggest milestones in my life. It was really exciting to get my degree and walk on stage and, you know, shake Chance's hand, to see all my other peers get their degrees as well.
Jeff Chi-Wei Gong.
My parents are there taking pictures. It was awesome. My parents, they're so happy that I'm getting a degree. They're just so extremely proud. My dad always believed that I'm going to be a success. And, you know, this helps reaffirm his belief, I guess, in me.
And, you know, I want to, like, do backflip or something, but then you can't because you have all this stuff on. And I want someone like this that I'm putting into my degree. I want to get that picture. Okay. Yeah, here.
Maybe in Hollywood, or maybe as a big CEO of a big biotech company, or maybe as a really hot and studly firefighter in the month of April on the firefighter calendar, or just someone, I don't know, just someone.